Hello everyone. So I like to play RPGs and strategies, but as you know, lately there's big lack of a good AAA strategies and RPGs. Last, of course, there is Endless Series, there is Stellaris, but in terms of RPGs, the last, basically the last good AAA was Witcher 3, and before that Dragon Age Inquisition, and before that Skyrim. So it was like 10 years ago. There's really, really very few good games now, which I hope will change soon with Cyberpunk. But for now, we really like maybe Outer Worlds. Good enough to play, but basically now we lack real good games, AAA level. So I decided instead of trying to find something good among a lot of random, not very good, but very beautiful games that come out now, we can just go back and play not so famous, but still very interesting RPGs. And the one I want to play now is a series of games made by Spiderweb Software. This one is Abaddon series. It might be not so fun as Shadowrun, but it's still a very interesting game. And it have very interesting exploration and very interesting stories, and it has a bit of its XCOM vibe also. We have a team of explorers and we will see how it will go. So let's start a new game. We can choose among many types of characters. Basically, a Blade Master is a warrior, Shadow Stalker is our thief, typical thief, can pick locks and design traps, okay, and Shaman is a healer and Sorceress is a mage. That's quite standard about a party of players. I should pick one. I guess that I'll have more people when I play it. Someone will join me. In other games of series, of this series, of other series, I can often build my own party. And then I take just one of each, because it's not clear which is better, which is worse, before playing the game. And also it's more fun when you see all types of characters, all types of professions in the game. But now we have to pick one. I think the most reliable pick will be a warrior, because we'll definitely need a tank, and while I suspect that we'll get tank soonish in the game, probably one of the first characters that will join our party, we still can spec our fighter as a damage dealer if we need, while other characters we can't really spec as tank. So I think we will choose a Blade Master here, a warrior. Tristram, that's fine name for us. Well, we will play this game on normal difficulty, because I always prefer normal difficulty, because it's how games supposed to play. Sometimes I prefer casual when game is not balanced well, and I don't like higher difficulties because it only adds more HP to the enemy and prolonged fights, but doesn't add anything interesting on you to himself, with very, very few exceptions. So we'll start it on normal. You are a warrior adept of the Midland Pact. The Pact is an alliance of five nations, banded together for safety. The Falands, enemies of the Pact, surround it on all sides. These are nations of barbarians, raiders, titans, faded, jealous empires, all waiting for a sign of weakness. So we'll be playing for humans, fighting against barbarians, just like often it goes. The Pact has one purpose: to crush the Falands and keep them weak and divided. Otherwise, they will invade your homeland, take what they want, and massacre whoever stands in their way. You have spent your life training and preparing to defend the Pact, and you have done well. Your skill and potential has earned you the greatest of honors. You have been sent to serve at a new fortress, Avadon. Avadon, the Black Fortress. The warriors of Avadon watch over the five nations of the Pact. When anyone acts to harm the peace and tranquility of the Pact, Avadon has the authority to destroy them. Its authority and independence are almost without limit. And Avadon's power is not only over the outsiders of the Farland. Anyone who tries to weaken the Pact from within is subject to punishment. Brigands, spies, politicians, all have reasons to fear the eye of the Avadon and the attention of its master, Keeper Redbird. Avadon has watched over the Pact for 3 centuries. Its warriors wield the finest weapons, its wizards can learn the most powerful spells, and the keepers of the Black Fortress, Redbird, direct them all. Few outsiders know anything about Redbird. There are plenty of rumors. Some say that he has 3 wives, each a deadly warrior. You've heard that assassins try to kill him every week. They all fail, and in turn receive the most gruesome punishments imaginable. Some believe that Redbird can see into your dreams. That's some character, of course. Outsiders, if they are lucky, never get close enough to Avadon to learn the truth. But you, today, you will meet Redbird yourself. You are standing outside the gates of the Black Fortress. You stand on the bridge, over a deep, misty chasm. The iron gates of Avadon are before you. Beyond is your new life, full of adventure, danger, power, wealth, and service to the Pact. The Black Fortress looms over you, perched on an enormous granite peak. The gates open a crack granting your entrance. You step through, and your service to Avadon begins. Okay, so here we are. This is a 2D pseudo 3D game. And so here we are, Tristan, and I guess we are in front of Black Fortress, or we just entered it, probably. So let's take a look at us. Here we are, we have inventory. Oh yes, so we have a lot of items, unlike many other RPGs nowadays, which have like 2 slots, which is weapon and armor, and that's all. This game have a lot of different slots, a lot of different choices that you can make for your characters. Even though mostly it's the same basically choice that is a best choice, but still it's very fun to find out which one is good. And we can see for now we really don't have much items, just a dagger and a tunic and pants, but we'll find a lot more of them on the ground in our pack. We'll get to it soon. And we have our characters itself. That's very interesting. It's a very different tree from other trees they have in other game. So we have levels and attributes, strengths, dexterity, resistances to different kinds of damage. Oh, very interesting. We also have specializations, which increase some things that we have. Okay, we'll look into this later when we level up. I probably will look through all of that and choose which way we want to go. Also, it depends probably on what allies we get. And yeah, we can have also attack as melee and this range. Okay, well, let's go and see what we have here. Okay, you start to cross Abaddon's entire garden. Considering how terrified most of Linnaeus is of this fortress, I guess Linnaeus is our continent where we is. It seems rather pleasant. Ponds, nicely tended low. To the east is another pair of gates leading further into the fortress. So yeah, we're inside fortress already. A pair of guards wearing plate armor and wielding massive swords stand to either side. There is also an elderly man in long flowing robes. He has a pair of what looks like wolves in front of him. He's shouting commands at them. They don't seem concerned. Okay, let's do as we told and cross and see. Very interesting. What we have here. Craft Master Nicodemus. You get closer to the old man and his two wolves. Though from the distance you can see that something is not right about these animals, like their lack of hair and their purple flesh, and the veins throbbing all along their backs and legs. The man in robes is holding us up a scrap of meat and giving suggestions like stand, sit, roll over. The wolf creature doesn't respond. Then you get close, which gets an instant reaction out of them. They turn and look at you. Then they bare their teeth and begin to snarl. And like all good RPGs, we have a lot of choices. Not all of them are meaningful, but most of them are. At least you can see different reaction from your characters, other characters. Unlike most RPGs nowadays, actually, where you only have an option to accept quest or accept it later. Basically, that's it. But here we can actually try to talk with them and do some things. Could you control this thing? No, as you can see, I can't. I thought I might, but the old man sighs. The twisted wolf thing turn away from the pitiful scraps of meat that the old man offered them. You seem much softer and fresher. However, the old man and the guards don't seem to react to this. They just watch silently and with interest. Ah, so he's probably testing us. That's what one of answers is supposed to say. Is this meant to be some sort of test? The guards smile, perhaps thinking back to trials of their own, but the old man shakes his head. A test? No, you are a hand. You are supposed to aid in my work. You are supposed to aid in my work. This is your job. I will explain more when you are done. The creatures lurch clumsily toward you, one to your right, one to the left. Then they start to run. This bird, prepare to defend yourself. Okay, so you have a bit of combat now. Okay, you have little equipment, but you are not foolish enough to travel through the wilderness without a weapon. You prepare to reach the garden of the old man's pets. When the wolves attack, you will enter a combat mode. Okay, let's enter a combat mode. So, here, we stay on the same map as we are now. Then later should be overworld map, maybe not in this game, where when you encounter somebody, you will enter a special map, but most maps will still be like this, where you travel and fight at the same map. Normally you just travel like you travel, and when you fight, it's actually turn-based. So, now we can attack, dagger, shoot, it's a long bow which we don't have. Then we have abilities. Alright. So at this version it seems we only have abilities which are specific to our class, but in other games we can have few classes at once. So we can use attack and defend and heal and buff and everything at once. But for now we can only rely on what we have. Okay, so we have a healing, we have challenge, which are not too totally useless even now because it gave us regenerating. And we have savage blow, and also we can just attack. I'm not sure how exactly this will work. Turns to recover fatigue. Probably. Let's try. And attack this wolf. And. Yes. And then let's take a look at our abilities again. So, as you can see, we used our attack and then went to cooldown. So turn to Starcarrow is basically cooldown. I'm not sure what exactly fatigue is. Probably it's how much turns you need to wait till you can use the next ability. But since this only requires one fatigue, we can use new ability just next turn, which we will do. But we don't have any good ability to use now, which we have challenge and healing, which both regenerating abilities, but we don't really need to regenerate now. This wolf didn't even hit us. So we will just hit it with attack again. And since we don't have any other attacks yet, we will just attack it with our melee weapon, with our dagger. And this time it didn't kill it because it's not the biggest damage, it's not as high damage, it's just 7 to 20 and it's a big random and it's not as much damage as this savage blow, but we still did some damage, so we'll, and he still don't hit us, we'll just finish it. The hideous wolf creatures lie at your feet dead. The guards, realizing that they have a mess to clean up, look annoyed. The old man just looks sad. Another month of work gone. I suppose I must work on my other trinkets for a while. I'm sorry. I'm Craftsman Nicodemus, one of the mages of Avernum. I think I will be helping you in the future. Okay, so let's see what he will be helping us with, and why did he call us hanged? So, you will be helping me? Oh yes, You are one of the Redbird's new hands, yes? When you are given tasks, I will be giving you the benefit of my magic. Some of it even works better than these constructions, he waves at the host. Yeah, it better should work better than these walls. Not to mention you did intelligence, they was very weak. I killed them with my dagger without sustaining any injuries. So better your other constructions be better. You called me a hand? Oh yes, Redbird has hands, eyes and hearts. I'm an eye and... Oh, I'm sure this will be explained inside. So I don't think that I will say, how dare you, because, well, he dares and I'm just a new recruit, so that's probably not the right attitude. I was glad to help. Nicodemus nods. That is the spirit, but you do not report to me. I was only trying to train the creatures here to get away from the chaos inside. I suppose you should see her, Miranda. I think she's waiting for you, and she will explain what you need to know. Where is her, Miranda? Casman Nicodemus makes a signal. The gates begin to slowly open. Miranda is inside, directing things. There has been a serious disturbance, and she will be happy for your help. Now please excuse me. Then he turns to his wolves, going down to one knee to examine them. Okay, let's go through the gates and see what we'll find. Oh, right. When no enemy is visible, we should just end our turn, so we won't stay in this turn-based part of the game. So let's end the combat. And now we can walk all around the place. And he'll go also somewhere where he wants. Our gates are open. But let's first take a look what we can take here. Maybe like steal something. Inventory. Okay, so there's nothing here. And here. Okay, so now we see clay ball and meat. Basically, items that don't have value and we'll see value are useless. Oh, there's no value actually in this here. I'm not sure if it exists in this game or not. But basically, items with no value sold for zero. And I know that clay bowl doesn't cost anything, it's useless. But we can eat it if we want. It heals us for a bit of heals. And we can put it into quick use items. Also scarabs, that's a very interesting idea. It's basically enhancement to our characters which we can get, and we need to put it inside the fortress, or at least at allied place, I'm not sure. But let's see when we can pick it up, we'll look at it more. For now, we only get meat, which wasn't fed to the wolves. That's still better than what we had, which was nothing. You step into the entry courtyard of Avernum. Fresh supplies are stacked everywhere, waiting to be distributed to the warriors and craftspeople. When Avernum wants something, it gets it. However, the atmosphere of the fort is not what you expected. It is chaos. Guards and workers are running everywhere. You hear shouting in the distance. The smell of smoke and you think blood hangs in the air. After a lifetime of hearing how deadly and invulnerable Avernum is, this chaos is somehow even more worse. A woman stands in the middle of the courtyard, an island in the chaos, and directs the workers. This must be the Miranda you are supposed to present your letter of introduction to. Okay, let's find our Miranda. And we can find it by just looking at the names, I think there should be okay, tab brings up minimap closer. I can't find the button which is supposed to show the names. Okay, here we are. Shift shows us all the names that we have here, and we can easily find this way who we want to talk to. And obviously, if it's just Aradon Guard or Avalon Walker, they are basically characters that they just there, they don't talk, they don't give you anything. But if you see someone with a name, that's probably someone important who can give you a quest or something or sell. Well, they're worth talking to. And we want to talk with Hurt Miranda. Okay, let's talk with Hurt Miranda. Come to me, says Hurt Miranda. Okay. So, you walk up to the woman in the middle of the room. Like craftsman Nicodemus, she's wearing long flowing robes, the traditional garb of the mage. She's in her early 50s. She has served here for a long time. She stops shouting orders and twinkling. Well, pity you didn't show up just a few hours ago. We could have used you. Do you have a letter of introduction? Fortunately, you were given one before you came here. She holds out her hand for you. Give the letter. We can ask other questions later, probably. I hope. She takes the letter, reads it, and nods. Then, I formally welcome you, Tristram, and I declare you a hand of Avadon, with all privileges and responsibilities attached. Congratulations! She wraps up the letter and tosses it on the floor. A servant instantly collects it and carries it off. Normally, there would be a period of settling in, tasting, and so on, but we have had some problems. All of our hands are out in the field, and there is something I need you to do now. Okay, that's some manager here. But first, what is this hand you're talking about? I'm a hand? What does it mean?
So much to learn, so little time to teach it. Avalon has hands, eyes, and hearts. And the keeper. I am a herd, an honored advisor to the keeper. You are a hand. Your job is to go out and do what needs doing. There will be time to learn more when things are under control.
Okay, so it looks like hands is operatives in the field, herds are managers, and eyes probably spies. That looks like that makes sense. So that's why she's hurt, Miranda, because she is a advisor here and manager. So let's know if she don't want to talk about it now. Where can I learn more?
Where can I learn more? I think there is a book on the topic near the quarter assigned to you. You can read it at your leisure later.
And who is the keeper?
Surely you have heard of Redbeard, mighty master of Avadon. Do well, and you will stand before him, displease him, and...
She gives you an evil smile. Okay, since that she don't want really talk with us much, and she just send us to... Well, where she did send us? Somewhere she probably should give us quests, so we should ask about it now. Okay, let's ask another question. And Hurt Miranda is still directing the workers and guards. She barks out a constant string of orders, which are all instantly obeyed. It is fair to say that everyone is terrified of her. Which makes sense. I'm not sure if you're interested to know about her at the moment, but we definitely want to know what happened and what she wants us to do. Okay, let's ask who she is. Can you tell us about yourself?
What? Security is broken, dozens are dead, and you want to know who am I? I'm a herd of Avadon. You will do everything I say, or you will suffer. I think that is clear enough.
Okay, that's kind of a reaction I expected from her. That's why I didn't really want to ask this question. But that didn't seem to hurt us, so let's ask more questions. Maybe that will hurt us. No, probably it will. It wouldn't, but not in this case. She needs us. But we definitely want to know what happened and what we actually need to do. So what has happened here?
You will soon learn that in Avadon you are taught only what you need to know. That is for your protection and ours.
Who decide what I get to learn?
The Keeper and the Herds, like me.
And what do I have to know?
That we are having a very long day and you need to help us to keep it from getting longer.
Quite a history she has here. Okay, so now let's ask her what she needs us to do, and maybe we'll find someone more adequate. Maybe. What do you need me to do? She knows.
Yes, enthusiasm. That is what I like to hear.
Of course, after we ask her so many questions, that's enthusiasm.
We are trying to get things in the main fortress under control, but we have had to spend most of our hands away.
To send most of our hands away.
That means we need you to enter the dungeons and restore order. Round up some stray prisoners. You don't need to go alone. There are two hands who can help you. They are Sevelin and Nathalie, I believe.
She points to the south.
On the way down to the dungeons, you can choose one of them to help you.
Okay, and just as expected, we'll get more company now. Maybe we'll get both of them later.
Once you have met the other hands, go downstairs and speak with Aim Mamora. He will tell you what fires to put out.
Okay, so I is probably out of fires, and now we'll get our team. Who are Sevelin and Nathalie? We probably can ask themselves. Then ourselves, she don't want to speak with us much. So what we just need to know what exactly we need to do. Finally get to the point. What do I need to do in the dungeons?
That is up to Aim Mamora. Do what he says. You may use any equipment you may find, and if you survive, it will reflect very well upon you.
Very, very nice joke. Okay, if we survive, it will reflect upon us well. Okay, that's really vague, I understand. But probably we'll just ask that I will tell us more than this. Right? So we'll go right away.
I will go right away.
She knows.
Good. With luck, you will be more suitable to serve than the other available hands. Go.
Okay. Go to the dungeon. We have a new quest. The recent disruption has enabled many prisoners in the Avadon dungeons to escape. Go south and speak with Sevelin and Nathalie, the hands who can help you to regain control. Then go downstairs, find Aim Mamora, and do whatever he tells you to do. Okay, so we'll do that very soon, but first I can see some items here on the ground, and since she said we can take whatever we want, we probably try to do that. Let's take a look. So here on the ground we have boots and shoes, and they go to the same place, to here, and they're a bit different. You can see boots are better. We will keep shoes for now. Maybe someone else will want to use it. But we'll put boots on and we'll get additional armor. Let's take a look at our armor. Here, armor is a resistance against physical attacks, basically. And we just added 5 more percent to it. It 10% doesn't seem like much, but as we progress, we'll soon get 50% or more, and maybe even more. And that will be very good to defend against enemy attacks. So let's wait for that and get as much items as we can, which lying around. Let's take a look what is lying on your table. Maybe we can get something from it for free. Oh, we have a candle that gives us a light source. If we'll go to the dungeon, and we'll go to the dungeon very, very soon, we'll probably need this candle to see. Or maybe it will only let us see better, which is more likely. Yeah, go to dungeon, go to dungeon. Okay. And here we also have one more hand which stands here doing nothing. Maybe we should go and look around also. Let's talk to this hand a bit. First, a middle-aged woman crosses the courtyard back and forth, shouting orders to the soldiers and workers. As hands enter and leave, she grabs them and gives them extra jobs to do. She wears a well-worn bow over her shoulder, and the insignia on her shoulder shows her to have considerable authority. She looks you over. A new hand? Always good to see, especially in times like this. I'm Hand Callan. Her Miranda will want most of your time, I think, but when she doesn't have her clothes on in you, you answer to me. Oh, so that's our probably side quest giver. There should be a lot of different side quest givers. So I want to talk with all named people here. And they often have something interesting to say or some interesting background about for themselves or for the game. So we want to talk with all of them, if possible, if we are not too bored. And let's see what she has to say. So what are you doing here? Okay, let's ask her. She loves cleaning up messes. Why don't you come back and talk to me later? Miranda has made it clear that she reserves your labor for herself, and I don't need an argument right now. Go talk to her. Okay, we already talked to her. So Calanda returns to work, we will return to work too. But probably before going to quest, which is going here, we'll go a bit all around and try to find a few items which we can use. Okay, so here it is closed, we can't go in. Let's take a look what we have to the east. And here it is also closed, so we don't have much choice, and we don't have probably for now side quests. So we will just go and look for our main quest. You enter Avadon's main store, where most of the food, wood, and so on brought to the Black Fortress are kept. There has recently been a fight here. The stone floor is scorched, and splatters of blood dot the walls. The wounded and dead have been hauled away. Only one person is visible from here. A young sorceress stands by the scorched area, looking down at it. She's smiling. Okay, let's take a look at, and it's Nathalie, one of the who we can take. Nathalie is probably a sorcerer, right? A mage damage dealer, magical damage dealer. Okay, here we can walk around a bit, actually. So let's walk around a bit and see if we can steal something else, like amphora. Probably we'll take amphora. Maybe we can steal it. I'm not sure. And let's take a look what is here. There's also doors. There is some crates which probably have something for us. Yes, bolt of claws. So it has, as you can see, that's what I was talking about. It has value of 30. That's something we can sell, and we definitely want to take all these items which have value and sell it later. Some of them might be useful for quests as well. So I will probably keep some number of them, and some of the items I will just keep and not sell. Unless I know that I don't need it for quests. But for now, we definitely want to collect all of them. So we can have it for later quests or for money to sell. Okay, so this animal skin is a more unique item. And this is craft item. We don't need much of this craft item, but it is useful, that I know for sure. Maybe we don't want such simple animal skin, but better animal skins we definitely need to keep, because we can make good items from it with our crafter. You remember we already met a crafter, and probably he will make something for us, or maybe there will be some blacksmith. So we want to keep such items. Here we can't enter as well. Probably it will be opened later. Let's take a look what's behind these doors. I can't open it because I don't have lockpicks. I see, I need two lockpicks. It's a bit different from what I saw in other games of this company. But, oh, here I need 12. Maybe if we had a rock, he will have a skill that reduces number of lockpicks needed. Maybe. And then we can open this door without even needing any lockpick at all. But for now we can't enter. We are warrior. Okay, and suddenly when we are exiting, we get this pop-up which we would want when we are entering. But okay, there are several locked storerooms back here. They probably contain valuable equipment reserved for someone important. Though, considering the chaos, you doubt anyone would mind if you borrowed something. However, to get the locks open, you will need to find some lockpicks. Use your lockpicks to pick locks, alas the picks break when used. Shadow walkers and soakers have skills that reduce the number of picks you need to open up. Yeah, I guess that's right. So actually not just shadow walkers, but also soakers have a lockpicking abilities. That's very nice. Okay, so maybe we wouldn't even need shadow walkers unless they needed to disarm traps. Okay, and now I'm interested actually in that sorcerer. Okay, let's take a look. Is there something I can pick around here? It doesn't look like I have. Maybe there's pots. Maybe these pots, because sometimes they can be picked. No, it doesn't seem like they can be picked. So let's go and talk probably with our sorceress, which we'll probably take with us since she can open locks. And let's look around. Is there something else to pick? No, it doesn't seem so. Back at the fourth row, maybe they can be useful, but probably they won't. So let's talk with our Nathalie. Nathalie, yes. When you get close to the young sorceress, she looks up at you. She is breathing hard, still charged with adrenaline from the recent battle. I did it! I killed them! By myself! Now that I will get any notice for it, of course. She takes a moment to calm down. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm Nathalie.
A hand of Abaddon. I have spent long enough waiting for action that I need to take a moment to luxuriate in it.
Okay, now she's happy to talk with us, unlike that hurt.
So we'll talk with you.
And probably she will tell us what actually happened here. So what happened here?
Three wretches came out of the dungeon. I was in the main courtyard when I heard them. I surprised and despite them, but not before.
Wretches?
Vile little humanoids, dumb and hungry. The scourge of the gnome lands. I don't know why that bird would bother to keep them around.
So that's probably orcs or goblins, I guess. We'll see. Did they do any harm?
They killed the quartermaster, not a warrior, but a good man. I spent many hours speaking with him while waiting for something to do. A minute earlier and I might have saved him.
That's a pity. They killed quartermaster. We don't have now where to sell our stuff. That's bad thing that they killed him, right? Let's talk more. I'm a hand as well. She nods.
You have the look and the weapon. I hope you have more luck getting sent out than I do.
It seems like we'll be sent out a lot. That's the game about it. After all, probably we wouldn't be sitting all the time in this fortress. So let's go and clean the dungeon. I'm going to clean out the dungeon. She looks startled.
What? You? No offense, but you have been here, what, 10 minutes? When some of us have been waiting.
Once again, she calms down.
But you will probably need help. In that the case, taking one of the other hands with you to find your the glory. Yes?
Yes, of course, I will happily take you with us. So you have been wanting to go fight.
Of course, I have spent my life working, training, and sharpening my talents to fight for Abaddon. All these years, sun up and to sun down, and my reward, sitting in the Black Fortress, waiting to be allowed to risk my life. Yes, I want to fight, and I ask and ask, but here I stay.
Okay, so you really like your job in fighting? Not like most workers, I guess. I think many would like to be in your place, like sitting in this fortress, doing nothing, getting payment. That's a good thing, you like your job, you know, and you want to do it. I want to have you with me. I can take the one hand into the dungeons with me. It doesn't take you long to do the math.
One hand, one out of two, me and Sevelin, the warrior. Well, speak to Sevelin and compare.
She looks at the scorch marks.
I'm eager and competent. He is, well, you can see for yourself. When you go downstairs, if you wish, I will come and join you. But you will select me, yes?
I think I will select you because I'm already a warrior myself. So probably I would like to have a mage with me. I hope she don't overspend on her mana. Maybe she has similar system that we have with fatigue. Anyway, we already have border and we want someone shooting for the backline. So I think we'll take her now. I think I will choose you. She nods. You see the gleam of enthusiasm in her eyes.
All right, you will not regret the decision.
When you enter the dungeons, you will be able to choose who travels with you. Okay, so I don't have her here now, and so I can't use her to open the door that requires lockpicks. So maybe it made sense to start a shadow walker. Myself. Okay, that's unfortunate, but what can we do? Okay, and here's our other hand, friend. Unfortunately, you can take both. Let's take a look first what we have here. And we have gloves, that's great. We have 2% more armor and cap for 2% more armor. Well, it doesn't look much like plate armor. But we'll have plate armor eventually. For now, we'll have to do with what we have. At least now our armor is 15%. Not much better. Okay, let's go and find something more. We will, right? Stone blocks, probably would need that. What we have here? Oh, wine. Wine don't have any cost, but maybe we will have a quest with wine. Somebody would want wine. Some barman or something. Then we'll give it to him and get XP. So I will take all the wine I can, I think. And let's talk with this guy. We already chose that sorcerer, but let's talk with him anyway. There is a young warrior standing guard by the passage to the south, keeping close watch in case anything else nasty comes out of it. Oh, he is more responsible, looks like. He turns to look at you. You see that he is about your age. His face bears a nasty scar running diagonally down his face. He says, "Greetings, I'm Sevelin. You are here to stand guard with me?" "No, I suppose not. We need to go fight now, don't we? I knew the time would come. I'll follow my orders, I always do." And yes, he's responsible, but he don't really have any initiative. Well, that's kind of expected from warrior, I think. So you have been wounded. Do you need help? I suppose Sevelin isn't sure what you mean. He looks down at his armor, looking for signs of an injury. Then he realizes that you are referring to his scar and laughs bitterly. "You mean this? This is an old mark. Easy to forget it is there. I only remember it when I look in the mirror, or when a stranger sees me." Okay, let's ask him how did it happen, why not? He looks exasperated. "Even if I enjoyed discussing it, this is not the best time." Makes sense, okay, bye, and you can still fight. Of course, if I'm ever chosen for a mission again, well, I guess I would rather take that sorcerer for now, especially since I'm really tank kind of myself. So I'll take this Natalie. Yeah. Right. I already chose her, so probably I don't need to do anything else. And we'll just go to the dungeons now. You are at the entrance of the Avadon Dungeons, a final resting place of many foolish enough to fight the pact. You notice that a heavy cloak has been left on a table nearby. It might be wise to put it on before descending into the low tunnels. Okay, so there is more things for us to take. We'll gladly take it, this cloak, additional 3 armor, 3% armor, and now we have 17 armor, well, not 0 at least. Let's open this gate and go, probably wouldn't die right away, right? This wheel controls the gate to the dungeons. With great effort you turn it as the gate opens, clearing your path to the dangerous depths below. Let's go in and take we don't have anything more. We have shackles here, but we probably don't need that. We won't be shackling these escapees, we will be killing them, I guess. So let's go in. And you are allowed to take one ally with you on the mission. Select someone to fight by your side. Okay, that one. Okay, we'll take Natalie. It seems like we'll have 4 total characters. Probably Sevelin will be not with us, since we chose a warrior already. But two others might come in handy as well. There is probably healer, and this one should be shadow walker, I think. And that looks like that from the silhouettes. So we taken this sorcerer and let's look what we have here at our dungeons. So we have more lamps here. We'll take it. Maybe we can light up our adventure a bit. I don't think we need a rope. And let's go and look what we find here. Okay. Press these buttons to use items. Yeah, that makes sense. Use that at the doors into the Abaddon dungeon, possibly the most terrifying place in Lynneus. The most dangerous conspirators against the Pact are brought here. Every once in a while, one of them emerges again. It is dark down here. In the absence of the guards, the lights have gone out. Happily, several lamps have been left out the table nearby. Gate lamp and when it's back, press the star button next to you to use it. You can use scrolls and potions the same way. Okay, that makes sense. So, let's take a look. We can press this button to eat meat or burn candle for whatever turns. We can't really drink wine. Okay. Or we can press it right here on the quick menu bar. And let's take a look how candle will look like. Yes, now we can see much better. So let's go in and take a look about this goblin sorks, whatever. You walk into the dungeon. Normally, the torches would be lit and heavily armed guards would be standing at attention. The jailers would be waiting to collect and process new inmates, and there wouldn't be giant rats everywhere. But the disaster upstairs has left everything abandoned. You can hear shouting and snarling in the distance, but the entry chamber is cold and dark, but not still. As you step onto the walkway, little pairs of light appear in the shadows to the south. Then they start to move towards you, with the guards gone. The pests in the tunnels far below Abaddon have started to emerge. Okay, so we have a... Wow. Rats. Okay. In other games, they don't move by themselves when we don't move. But here it seems different, so they actually move at the same time as us in real time. It's not very good, but well... What we can do? So we can try to kill them. I don't think we have enough. We can't get to them, I think. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, we can't even get to them. So probably we will stay here. We can stay here, right? Alright. And now we have our mage, and she has a rod. She can shoot. That's good. She can shoot it too far, I think. And let's take a look at her abilities. Shadow Charm for less likely to attack you. Blade Shield for turns. Okay, Daze. Daze all enemies in the area, leaving them unable to act for a time unless you damage them. That's not bad. That's probably what you want to use. Okay, let's see. We can use it right here, right? And there's all these rats at once. Yeah, and they actually taste. So let's get close to them now and pick them one by one. We have one more move, as I thought we can get to them right away. So let's move this one too and shoot this rat. Let's shoot. She can't hit us and those rats are still there, so let's kill them just one by one, slowly but steadily. our mage is shooting fireballs. Oh, that's an interesting status effect. So all of us can get some status effect, as you can see. Tristram had status effect of light, and because of that we can see everything better. And this red has a status effect of terrified. It's because it has very low health, and it's not always happen when enemies is at low health, as you saw before we damaged other enemies and they was not terrified, but it can randomly happen. And terrified mostly means that they try to run away or just don't attack us. So, but we will still kill it because it's good when others can also move, and it actually can move now also. But I think we'll still kill this red first. Other threats are quite far away from us. Maybe they can't get to us in this turn. So we'll finish this red, which is terrified. And then we'll try to take them down also. That wouldn't be one by one, but they don't really damage us. We only lost one health so far. So we'll just kill them, and probably we'll use our abilities later when we'll get to some more serious enemies than just rats. Okay, let's kill this huge rat and shoot that one. Okay, now we killed her in just one shot. I think we'll finish this one with our savage bow. Okay, so now we kill them. We also gained some XP, I think. Let's end combat first and take a look. Yeah, we get some XP from killing each of them, and eventually we'll get our level up. After fight we actually restored our health, but not our vitality. I guess vitality is what they call fatigue, and which is required to cast spell, right? Probably right. Anyway, let's take a look at what we have here. We have more barrels with more ale, and probably someone would want this ale as well, not just wine. So we'll take it. Enemies normally can't open their door, so when we go around the place, we would want to look at everything that is not open, that is already open first. Like a rule, not always, but mostly, and then open the door. Okay, so probably we'll have our quest at the top, so maybe we can go to the bottom and first open the door and look at what we have there. Suddenly a reassuring light appears to the north. Someone has just lit a torch. He shouts, "Is that support at last? Come here, quickly!" This is a good time to start the game if you haven't already. Okay. I see what you want. Yeah. We'll have a difficult fight now. So we'll save it. Yeah, let's save it. And let's go take a look what is behind the door. Probably. And the door is locked, you don't have the key, and the lock is too complex to be picked. Okay. We can't really open it, so we don't have much of a choice, just to go north and do our quest. You emerge into a large office. A fence rings an area with decks and shelves heavy with records. New inmates are brought here and set down, while scribes record their arrival, crime, and recommended processing. There are some chains and cages, usually used for wild beasts and monsters in need of examination. When humans are brought here, they are usually just left on the benches. You are foolish enough to think that they can escape from this place. There is a man in a ledger there jacking, standing by the far desk. He waves at you. A hand at last! Hurry! Let's take a look, who is it? Oh, he is coming to us himself. Okay, so yes, that eye which we had to find
and more. The last eye on the duty in the dungeons woke up to me. He is an aging man with a thick leather jacket and a broadsword held awkwardly in his hand. He nods to you. I'm I Mamora of Holglander, master of the Avalon dungeons. I'm pleased to see you, though I confess I thought that I might have been added earlier, and I might add with more force. But we will do what must.
Yeah, I honestly thought I also can take both other hands, but for whatever reason I can't. It didn't make much sense from a war perspective, but it makes sense from game perspective, like you need to choose someone. Okay. So this guy supposed to give us quest and tell us about all these orcs, goblins, whatever we're supposed to kill here. So let's ask him. Well, let's ask him first about what happened down here. What happened down here? I'm not sure. It is the result of something that happened above. Something I still have not been informed about. A pulse of energy from upstairs disrupted our magical wards, enabling some prisoners and held creatures to escape. They in turn helped others out. There was, as you might expect, a fierce battle. Some prisoners fled. Okay, makes sense. That's what we suspected happened in this dungeon. Except for this pulse of energy we didn't expect. But okay, where is everyone now? Many of the prisoners are dead or were returned to their cells. Some keepers were slain. What's that remain? There are abandoned tunnels under Avadan, and some pests have taken this change to emerge. They will need to be slain. Also, some prisoners are still loose on this level. Many of them will have been devoured by the pests. Others, however, will have to be hunted. Okay, so that makes sense. That kind of explains what we need to do. So we'll have rats and few prisoners here. And he already told us where these rats come from. He's probably master of the dungeons. Or temporary master of the dungeons, I would say. Okay, let's ask him. He not samurai. That is why I stayed when the others fled. It is my duty to stay and fight. In separate times, I look out for the prisoners. I keep them safe, which we need to do. And I pull from the information that Redbeard requests to protect the pact. Okay, so... and there's more information about prisoners. Okay, let's first ask him about everything. We can probably read this all. You keep prisoners safe, of course. We keep prisoners safe. Do they leave? Of course. That's a bit surprising. They actually let people leave sometime. Okay. And they just kill everybody they see as a threat. Okay, so they're not so much of a prison, like a middle-age prison. It's more like more modern prison, probably. Okay, he also told us about the rats. Right, that's an interesting question. Why haven't those cells been sealed off? Where these rats came from? We have considered expanding into them, rebuilding, and so on. This disaster is making me reconsider this plan. Ah, okay, that makes sense. So how can it go there? The stairway down to the old tunnels is in the secure cells. However, I can give you the key to the cells. You must obtain it from a superior, such as, say, Hand Khan. Okay. So, where do I go to find it? Help Callan? Maybe he's here also? So, okay, let's report to him officially. Miranda sent us to help you. I'm a Mormon. It is overdue. Now that we are again in full control of Avanon, it is time to retake the tunnels. They are infested by a wide variety of pests, rats, spiders, nothing surprising. They must be slain. Also, I have been questioning the keepers as they emerge from the tunnels and go upstairs to safety. There are 4 prisoners who are unaccounted for. These should still be out there in the shadows. You must find them or verify that they have left this level. I closed the gate to the inner case when I saw that the prisoners were loose. I will try to open it for you. Okay. So, do we need to find them? Okay. Must they be slain? They must be found as long as they are created and don't seem inclined to leave. You may spare them or not. As a hand, you have the authority to decide their fate. Okay, so we basically John Shepard. We have authority to do whatever we need, and then we only answer to our heart and to that red bear guy who can kill us when he wants. Not very fun perspective, but still much better than most people in this continent, probably. As a hand who can do whatever need to be done and decide whatever fates. So, who are the prisoners I need to find? Therefore, he consults a scroll. A wretch named Gross? Whatever. A chameleon savage named Hansi. A tricky young mage from the Tauan Empire named Quoria. And most dangerously, Shadow Tarkus. Of course, the treacherous creature did not hesitate to try to slip away. As the keepers emerged, they told me where they last saw the lost prisoners. Okay, so this quest seems to be really long. I think I'll just ask him about all of them, and in the next part, we'll go and try find them and get all the stuff. So, tell me about the wretch, which I suppose orc, right? Gross is a sniveling little creature. We were trying to learn who was selling weaponry in the wretch lands. He knew nothing. We were going to release him, though he may have jeopardized that mercy by trying to escape. Okay. Tell me about Chimerians. Chimerians are barbarians, shamans, and warriors of the plains. Truly savage and cruel. Not like our allies in the Wildrill. Hansi was leading raiding parties into Wildrill lands. Happens often, but we need to make an example of them occasionally. Hansi surrendered all of the information to us freely, so we were planning to release him. Okay, so he's not a threat, you think. Okay, who is the Tauan Mage? A particular vicious rebel, truly filled with hate for us. She was spying in Kalimdril? Samelan City, probably. Do we have else here? Probably not. Okay, so she was spying, and when we caught her, I hope she can be spared. The scrying of your mind was going well. We had found the existence of some conspirator named Alice in the Tauan Empire. I am eager to find more. Alice, probably that's name, evil guy, if I had to guess. Okay, and who is Shadow Tarkus? A spy and assassin, a blade for hire, a killer for coin. However, he only works to harm the pack and the warriors of Abaddon. Capturing him was very difficult and required a good deal of luck. If you find him, you may wish to get help as quickly as possible. By now, he's sure to have armed himself. He's very dangerous. Might he be responsible for your problems? The possibility has occurred to me. However, it is unlikely.
He has been continuously chained with our most secure spells. Whoever caused this disaster, it was not him.
Okay, thanks.
Thanks, guy, and what is the name? I have new quest to go and secure the dungeons, find these guys, and slay or kill them peacefully. I'm Mamora. Okay, Mamora, whatever. Let's take a look what we can steal here. Expropriate, right? Not steal, we don't steal. Actually, they're stealing this game, I think, but we don't steal. We just take whatever is lying around unprotected, like this. Okay, here we get another dagger. I don't think we need another dagger, but maybe. I'm not sure if we'll have... we can put two daggers? No, we can't. But okay, let's keep this dagger for now. Why not? Here we also have some papers, dice. I don't think anything of this will be useful. Let's take a look what we have here. And here we have coins and potion of recovery. All inactive abilities return 6 turns earlier. Yeah, that might be useful, but probably we'll sell it instead. Still, that's coins, so we'll take it. And here we have potion of healing, and that is useful. I think healed by a lot. And how much HP we have? 65. So it healed very randomly, but well, yeah. Let's take a look at open spaces first, and then we'll go to the door, I think. And we have a red here. Okay, let's kill that red. Where have you gone? Okay, here we are. Reds, let's kill you. We can just start combat like this. And yeah, we have variety of abilities. Yeah. We know about it already. So let's just wait for these reds to come. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, we can go safely somewhere here. And then just try to shoot them with our mage. We can get here, I think. No, we still can't shoot. Okay, now we can attack it with our abilities, because why not? I don't see much other enemies that will be damaged. So let's kill just fast, take minimum damage, and shoot it. Oh, and she went around our tank, which is not great. So I suppose we should actually cast that spell which make them not attack our mage. And our tank, maybe he will have also some more shells. Okay, so now we kill these rats, maybe there will be more. But for now, let's just look around at these shells. Oh, yes. And we immediately have more of them. Let's stay here. And they come in. There's a lot of rats this time. They're not dangerous, but still we'll have to kill them. Maybe we'll use this. Or should we use clock so that they would attack our mage? I don't think there is big difference in HP between mage and our tank for now. Later we'll probably need to use this shadow charm, but now let's just kill those rats. Get back a bit, kill this rat. And kill more rats. What's good now, they can't really get past my warrior. They can go around in theory, but they don't, because probably because my mage is quite far away.
and they can't really get move right next to me because they lost a lot of ability points, like these moves. And so, yeah, looks like we finished. I hope so. I hope we killed all the rats, at least in this particular area. There is nothing much to look here at. Let's take a look at the cells. Oh, that's probably not the cells, it's probably kitchen. Maybe there's some red. No, there's just trash, nothing else. There's nothing much with this. In this particular kitchen, okay. Okay, let's go to the next place. What we have here on the table? Some blankets. Oh, an animal skin we'll take. If nothing else, we can sell it. And I don't know. Okay. Here we have boards and more trash. Nothing interesting. Okay, so here's an open door. Let's take a look. And we have more rats. Okay, let's kill rats. That's a good source of experience. If nothing else. Now, we actually missed a rat. Wow, that's surprising. And we didn't even finish it. Wow. That's really some unlucky rolls, but I guess, well, you have to deal with it. And now we have a bit less HP, but maybe it's a door. And now we have a spider too. It seems like spider is stronger than rats. Which kind of makes sense, like this giant spider. No, I'm actually not sure if rats are stronger than spider or otherwise. But that's fantasy, so, well, who cares? Now we killed all of them. And they didn't drop anything, but maybe there is something in this room. Yes, really, there's some shells, there's something probably inside, not really. Oh, and we have iron short sword, and that's very good. That's very good for us. We won't give it to our mage, but we'll definitely give it to our melee guy, since it also gives us plus 2 melee damage additionally. Can we take two? No, we can't. We take two with us once. Okay. Well. Still, you can see that daggers cost nothing and iron short sword costs something. But we will still, maybe we'll need it later for other characters. So, later we'll see. Is there anything useful here? Pillow, blanket, towel. Nothing that we can sell, so we'll just ignore it. Oh, right, wait. So here's also such thing as weight, and we can see that we are. It only matters how much we're wearing and not how much we have on our back. So it's kind of surprising, but that's actually a good thing because we don't need to go back home all the time just to sell all this trash we collected. At the same time, we have some limit. We can't put too heavy weapon on someone who don't have much strength and so on. Well, now we have 22 whatever pounds probably, and we will be encumbered at 64. There is different. If we are encumbered, it's not good, but it's different in the different games. Maybe we will get to that. We'll try to avoid getting encumbered, but if we'll get to it, well, we'll see what it does. Oh, actually, we have a laser shoes, which we probably should give to our mage, because she didn't have anything at all. It's better than nothing, maybe. 2%. Okay, let's go. further, and maybe we can have something else to pick. Apparently, there was a lot of fights with mages and stuff. We can see burn marks everywhere. And what we have here? Oh, we have mushrooms. I don't know if mushrooms are useful. Like, we can eat to heal ourselves, but you can see we already healed back. So we can only really use it when we fight, but they heal for very little. Maybe someone would want mushrooms in the quest. Well, we will see. We'll see about it. And here we also don't have anything useful. A lot of trash and stuff. And okay, so that we can go further. And we have a back door here. Let's take a look first at these open places. Let's be careful. Okay, so it's empty actually. Except that we have a helm. Oh, great! We have a helm. Let's put it on and give this cap to our mage, which is more appropriate for her. And we have a mug here. So we would not go to this door for now. Let's take a look what we have here. Probably have a lot more here. So let's go back and look at these doors, which were closed. We need more lock picks. Alright. Let's take a look at our mates and see if a lock charm is number of lock picks that are acquired whenever your group attempt to pick a lock or disarm a trap. Increasing this skill also makes its ability far more effective. So actually we have one, right? Right, we have one charm, but I can't really see it here. Probably it's kinda passive, maybe. But then the question is, how I can open it? I still need one more lockpick. Probably it requires two lockpicks initially, and she reduces the number of lockpicks acquired by one, so I still can't open it. That's it. Let's look at another door. It's probably also closed. I can't open it. It can't open at all. It requires a key. Okay. So let's go further and look for more troubles, for more rats or spiders or something. This is a wide natural cavern. It must have been discovered years after Abaddon was constructed. It was then converted into one of the field workshops of the Black Fortress. There are about a dozen stone tablets scattered about the room. Each has restraints, a glowing enchanted stone, a chair, and materials for taking notes. It is here that the prisoners of Abaddon are brought, so that the eyes can use powerful magic to pull their thoughts out of the mouth. Once here, a prisoner has no secrets. Everything they planned, everyone they conspired with, all of that precious information goes straight to Remnant. Okay. So we played this game for quite a long time already and didn't have much fights except with these rats. So probably we need to make some cut here and return back next time. So unless this rat will trigger our fight. So let's return next time, guys. See you. Bye bye.